Well, hello guys, Pokeplayer, and today I'm back for another video. And today's video is a new Wi-Fi battle, and this Wi-Fi battle was against the Rizzle, aka Thomas. He is a very good friend of mine, and he is the organizer of the NUCL League, which is really cool, so you should check out his channel. And today we are having a little cup battle, and it's not the best quality, I know guys. I don't have a capture card of my own, so I had to record this with my regular camera today, but I've brought some pretty cool stuff, and my opponent brought some pretty cool stuff as well. And it's always fun to have a little cup battle, because you don't have them too often, because not everyone has the right thing to make a level 5 Pokemon. And we both did, and we had some pretty cool teams. So I went for the Protect right here, because I just wanted to get my guts off. I kind of felt like his Magnemite could be scarred, so I decided not to risk it and just regularly switch out into my Drowsy, because Drowsy can take those hits. It's especially defensive Drowsy, and it looks really cool, to be honest. Look at Drowsy with those hands and its nose. I really like Drowsy. It's one of the better designs, in my opinion, that they made this gen. So my opponent full switches out of there and goes into his Totodile, and I know that Totodile has the Crunch and it has the Sheer Force ability, which means that the Crunch will definitely kill me. He might even be Life Orb, so that will definitely kill me. But looking at this damage, he might not be Life Orb on his Totodile. He might be just the Firelight, but I'm not sure. I don't really know the damage output in Little Cup on Totodile, but it didn't do too much to my physically defensive Koffing, which was really nice. So right here, I just went for the Will-O-Wisp because I know that it will just regularly damage his team, which is nice. And he switches into his Spoink, which is a really cool Pokemon. I should definitely use a Spoink at some point, but I already have a Drowsy, so I don't really see a point to make a Spoink. But it's a really cool Pokemon, to be honest, how it bounces and stuff. But the Spoink goes for the Thunder Wave, which was really unfortunate. I was just hoping that he would go for the Psychic Tap move, but he probably predicted my switch into the Houndour, which was pretty predictable. But I just decided to switch it in because I was predicting the Psychic. So now my opponent goes into the Diglett, as I switch out, predicting his switch into the Diglett, which was a pretty decent play on my part, I have to say, because it was pretty obvious that he would switch into the Diglett, and most Diglets run the Sash. So right here I just went for the Drain Punch, I believe, or for the Ice Punch. I went for the Drain Punch, and it actually does not kill the Diglett, which was pretty surprising, because Diglett doesn't have any bulk at all. But this is an Ephialite Timber and not a Life Orb or something like that. So now I just went for the Ice Punch, predicting him to go for the Earthquake or for the Sucker Punch. So I just went for the Ice Punch because he could have switched into his Sentryu, which was an option for him as well. But he didn't do that. He just decided to sack off his Diglett, which was okay. But right here I have to preserve my Timber, because I know that this Seraphine is going to be a problem to my team, because I don't have enough priority to kill it. And my opponent goes for the Leaf Storm, and it does so much damage to my Taillow. Taillow is by the way the MVP of this match. I didn't know that Taillow was such a good mon in Little Cup, but you guys will see how well it does in this battle. So now my opponent switches out, and I decided to go for the Facade, because I don't want to get any extra damage off with the Brave Bird. I go for the Facade and do over half to this Sentryu. This Sentryu should be defensive, which is really nice. And now my opponent switches into his Magnemite, which is his winning condition. And right here, I would have never been able to kill him without a crit, but I crit him on this turn, which is really important, because his Magnemite was scarfed, that's what he told me after the battle, and it could have been able to wreck my team. Well, yeah, it could have been able to wreck my team, because I don't have a good thing for it. My Drowsy can take its hits, but I only have Psychic and Toxic on that guy, I believe. So I'll go for another Facade, and I do die to my Toxic on this turn, which is unfortunate, but my Taillow did a great job this battle. I'm really proud of Taillow, and I should be using this guy more. It's a beast in Little Cup. So now I'm going into my Houndour, because I kind of felt like he would switch into his Snivy, and right here I was kind of predicting that he could maybe switch into his Spoink, so I just went for the Dark Pulse. And that does not enough. I should have gone for the flamethrower or fire blast, whatever I was running on this guy, but I just knew that I needed to get some damage off and I didn't want to miss my fire blast because I think that I'm running that. Since I'm scarfed, I need that extra damage. And I die from this leaf storm, which is unfortunate, but I do have my drowsy in the back. And my opponent goes for the taunt, predicting me to either rest or do something like a thunder wave. But I decided to just go for the psychic because I needed a little bit of damage off so that I could kill it with a mach punch with my timber, which was the main reason why I decided to switch in drowsy at the first place, because I know that the mach punch won't be able to kill it from the range that it was at before I switched it to my drowsy. So now he goes for another leaf storm, which is able to kill my drowsy. He's at plus 6, I believe, at this point, so I should be going for the mach punch right here. I could have predicted his switch, but luckily enough I didn't do that. That would have been such a misplay if I did predict that. And I just played it safe, go for the mach punch, and luckily enough that kills the Snivy, which is great, because that was one big threat out of the way. And now he doesn't have a lot of Pokemon left. I don't either. Don't have a lot of Pokemon left either. But I decided just to sack my guy off right here. I didn't see much use for him, to be honest, because I did not have a good switch into the psychic. I only have my my Koffing left and one more Pokemon, which was my my Kabutops, and that doesn't like to take the psychic, and I didn't know if I could outspeed it. But this is a defensive Kabutops, I believe, or it's my Rainlance. I think it's the defensive Kabutops with knockoff, Rock Slide, Stealth Rocks, and Rapid Spin, which is a really nice set. I really like it. And now my opponent goes for the Waterfall, and that does a lot of damage to my Kabutops. But I just went for the Rock Slide just to get some damage off, because I knew that if I got enough damage off, I would be able to kill it with a Sludge Bomb with my Koffing, which was a good thing. So now we are both, I'm down and we are both on our last Pokemon. I've got my Koffing in the back, which can kill it with a Sludge Bomb, which is nice. And he only has the Waterfall, and since he is Sheer Force, he can't flinch me with this Waterfall, which is nice, because that means that I can take at least one and retaliate with a Sludge Bomb, which is able to kill the Totodile. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I enjoyed this battle. I certainly did. It was a really cool Little Cup battle. We both brought some pretty powerful stuff and some pretty cool stuff. And well, I hope you guys enjoyed these battles. Leave a like if you did. And then I'll see you guys in my next video. Later.